And in this case, we wanted to monitor the effectiveness of treatment using the full-field ERG. And this first patient is an 84-year-old female who was diagnosed with diabetes in 2006 and developed diabetic macular edema around 2011. I treated both eyes. She was a pseudophakic, and her comorbidities included hypertension, hypercholesterolemia, and I had to treat her on multiple occasions. And this just gives you a summary of the right and the left eye treatment. And as you can see, we really had to do quite a bit. A lot of focal laser, MicroPulse, Avastin, Triescence, Lucentis, and then eventually I went to Iluvien in 2015. And in the left eye, she also had vitreomacular traction syndrome on top of the chronic DME. And so we did focal, MicroPulse, Avastin, Lucentis, also Jetrea to treat the VMT, Triescence, and pars plana vitrectomy, again for the VMT. And finally, Iluvien in 2015. So prior to the Iluvien injection, the visual acuity in the right eye was 20/40 and the intraocular pressure was 16. And on the left-hand side, you can see the fluorescein angiogram, which really nicely demonstrates the extensive diabetic macular edema with cysts of edema and open microaneurysms and some focal laser. And on the right-hand screen, you see the OCT that also demonstrates the multiple cysts. The left eye looked very similar, and her visual acuity in this eye was 20/50. The intraocular pressure was 16. The fluorescein on the left-hand side clearly demonstrates the many pockets of cystic edema associated with diabetic macular edema, the microaneurysms, and some focal laser. And on the right-hand side, we see a very similar picture with the OCT with multiple layers of edema. So the top line represents the fluorescein prior to Iluvien, and then in 2017, another fluorescein reveals how this patient looked after Iluvien. And you can see that there's quite a marked improvement and that there is way better control of the diabetic macular edema and a much less boggy looking macula. And in the left eye, it was a very similar picture. So the top row compares 2015 to 2017. And again, you can see that there's a distinct improvement in the diabetic macular edema. 15 months after Iluvien in the right eye, she was 20/25, and I had not had to do any further treatment. And you can see that there's nice foveal depression. In the left eye, a little bit of irregularity from the ILM peel associated with the pars plana vitrectomy, but she's 20/40 and no further treatment has been rendered either. And when we plotted the change of central thickness in the OCT over time, you can see as soon as we gave the Iluvien in 2015, there was a dramatic improvement in the OCT with a decrease in central thickness in both eyes. So how did we incorporate ERG testing with this? Well, I didn't have the technology in 2015, so I can't show you prior to Iluvien, but I can show you 2018 and 2019. And what I want to bring to your attention is that you can see with the diabetic retinopathy assessment on the top, it's 15, which is a really great number. So this gave me a lot of confidence knowing that for the time being, I had this patient well controlled and that I could push appointments out a little bit further. And then when we compare 2018 to 2019, again, you can actually see that we're within the normative database and that the implicit time and the amplitude looks really good in both eyes. So the full field ERG shows normal implicit time and amplitude in both eyes. The implicit time continued to improve on the follow-up of full field ERG. So you can see the patient had a strong response to Iluvien, not just with retinal structure, but also with retinal function. So I feel like the full field ERG allowed me to be more comfortable increasing time between appointments.